Time for a 5-minute deck tech, and this time around we've got a partner deck with Rayhan, Last of the Abzan, and Timna the Weaver. But it is Rayhan that takes center stage here in Negative Skews list, as this is a deck all about humans and putting +1/+1 counters on them, getting all sorts of value along the way as you go. There is a lot of stuff to get through with this deck. It is a very, very complicated and finely tuned machine, but basically boils down to, again, putting lots of counters on lots of humans and then using those counters for fun and profit with all sorts of different tricks of the trade and some super weird cards, including some new ones from Commander 2020 that you may only just be getting across. So let's get to it and have a look at what this list is all about, starting off with ways to make sure our humans get counters on them. Cards like Juniper Order Ranger not only puts counters on itself, but also other creatures when they enter the battlefield. Micaeus the Lunarch is a little Gavinny Township type effect, and also, don't forget, a human. There are some non-human enablers that also help us here. Metallic Mimic is actually technically a human and enables all of this +1/+1 counter nonsense for all the creatures that come after it, as indeed does Good Fortune Unicorn. Not a human itself, doesn't care if the creatures you play are humans, but still gets those good +1/+1 counters, as does this super new and super weird card from Commander 2020, Kazur, Ruthless Stalker. And this is a good way to make sure that, you know, some of the tokens you make or other cards that haven't got counters on them do get them, as long as they can connect and get in there. But also, take note, a legendary human. And there are plenty of legendary humans in this list, which is important, as we'll discover a little later on. Anyway, as you might expect, there are plenty of ways to make sure that we get extra counters. We're getting extra value with all the counters that we're putting on our creatures here, with things like Hardened Scales, Winding Constrictor. These are the usual suspects. This is really, really standard stuff in decks like these, as indeed is Corpjack Menace and Doubling Seasons. No surprises here. These are very, very normal cards in any counter-based deck because of what they do, you know, the way that they juice up and synergize so nicely with all the rest of the cards you've got. But Dearly Departed is definitely a weird one. Definitely a weird one that I think a lot of people forgot about, but of course perfect in a deck that has both a need for all these +1/+1 counters, not to mention, of course, the fact that we're mostly playing humans, so Dearly Departed a really great fit. But what are we doing with all these counters, I hear you ask? Well, again, I said that Rayhan takes center stage, and that's certainly the case. As it says here, whenever a creature you control dies, if it has +1/+1 counters, you get to put those +1/+1 counters somewhere else. And of course, if you've got a creature that dies with one, and you've got something like a Hardened Scales out, Rayhan actually puts two on another creature. It's a weird kind of modular type effect that it gets amplified, of course, by all of these other cards. And this isn't the only one. Plenty of other payoffs like Nikara, drawing cards whenever creatures with counters die, or Yawgmoth, which enables you to proliferate all of these counters, as well as some other cards that also have proliferate. But critically, and keep this in mind as well, lets you sacrifice creatures, which we'll come to in a second. And the Ozolith, if any of these creatures die, and you know how they die, well, it could die in any number of ways. Maybe we'll come to that in a second. But the Ozolith charges up, stores up those counters, so you can whack them on other new creatures a little bit later on. But it's not just counter payoffs that we're looking at here. There are also plenty of tribal human payoffs. And some of these cards, again, you see them in every single tribal EDH deck, stuff like Herald's Horn. But Thalia's Lieutenant, as not only a Gavinny Township type effect for all of your humans, also grows the more humans you play. And General's Enforcer, check this out. Not only does General Enforcer create more little human tokens, there are a couple of cards that do this, and General Enforcer is one of the best of them, also makes all of those legendary humans indestructible. And we've seen Rayhan, Nikara, Yawgmoth, Micaeus, there are so many others as well, Kazur, and General's Enforcer protects all of them, just, you know, from sweepers, from removal, outside of exile effects. It's a very, very powerful card to have. But this one's a weird one. Species Specialist. You play it as a 2/3, you name human. Why would you name human? Why are your own creatures dying? Well, here, my friends, is the prestige, because this deck is secretly an Aristocrats deck. There are lots and lots of ways to sacrifice your creatures for fun and profit in order to trigger Rayhan, in order to gain value off of all of, again, these, look at these, I mean, can't tell aristocrat, sure, whatever. I mean, that's not what we're interested in here. We're interested in deranged outcasts, the perfect card. Sacrificing humans, you got plenty of them. Putting plus one counters on other humans. Fantastic. Disciple of Gristlebrand, debuff your life total if things get a little hectic. Greater Good looks a little weird in a deck filled with, you know, two power creatures, but between Rayhan and all the other effects you've got to bolster your creature's power and toughness, it's not unlikely that this will actually end up with you being ahead on cards a lot of the time. But the final cherry on the top of this delicious cake is, of course, as this is an aristocrat style deck, how could we go past Taisa Karlov? Doubling all the effects that you gain from sacrificing creatures from Rayhan all the way down, Taisa is a wonderful, an incredible way to go over the top with all of these little 1-1s, these little 2-2s that you're sacrificing here and there, putting plus one counters all over the place and slowly but surely building out a board that can't be beaten. This deck has got so much going on for it. I mean, in 5 minutes, it's impossible to get across everything that it's trying to do. I cannot recommend this deck highly enough. It looks like so much fun. It's playing all these weird niche cards from years ago and bringing them together in this beautiful marriage of synergy, tribal synergy, plus one counter synergy. You really do love to see it. So thank you so much to Negative Skew for sending it in. If you'd like to do the same thing, please do on Twitter at Radicary Tower. And of course, if you want to see this list in its entirety, you can head over to bit.ly/human counters. But that is that for this 5-minute deck tech. Thanks so much for hanging out with me. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next time.